YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, in this video, we're going to go over the season ranks. I'm going to give you some tips and tricks, and in a nutshell, the fastest way to level up your season ranks. I am level 44 right now, and pretty much I've been doing everything that I'm going to show you in this video solo. And there's a number of reasons why you want to rank up your season ranks. One is you want to get all of the loot. Two, there's a number of seasonal bonuses down at the bottom, and of course, you want to level up and unlock everything from your seasonal artifact so you can start using some of those mods in there. If you find this video helpful, please hit that like button, subscribe if you're not a subscriber, but if you really want to help me out, become a channel member and join the Mesa Army and the Mesa Army Discord, and also, if you need a clan, we've got a Mesa Army clan for you on all platforms. Alright, let's get into it. First off, if you're lower in power, you can let those items that are armor, weapons, exotic engrams, you can let them sit there and then pull them as your power level goes up in order to fill in some gaps. So just an FYI. As you rank up your season ranks, well, the first thing you want to look at is the XP bonuses. You start off with a large XP boost, you get fire team XP boost, you get small XP boost, and I do believe they all stack, I think. One thing that I'm trying to get clarification on, and I can't, but maybe you guys can help me in the comment section, is if I'm with, let's say, a fire team of 5 or 6, and we all have the multiple small XP boosts, do they stack, or is it just a one-time small XP boost and you don't get any more benefit if you had one person in your fire team or if you had 5 or 6? I don't know. Let me know in the comment section. Another bonus you'll get is the currency bonus. Increases the currency drops from various sources: Glimmer Replicator and Legendary Shard Dismantler. Now, these are awesome. You know, at the beginning of the season, I was broke as a joke because I kept buying so many of the repeatable bounties and those cost 3,000 Glimmer. And now I notice I am constantly over 200 thousand just by playing the game, cashing in bounties, just doing activities, and yeah, this comes in very handy and you definitely want these unlocks. Next up, we have the quest bonus. Now, this is going to be for your catalyst. When you're working on catalysts, well, this will speed it up. Provides objective acceleration to their respective quests, and you've got Catalyst Quest Boost Alpha and Catalyst Quest Boost Omega. Then you have a masterwork bonus, so grants additional masterwork and energy levels to season pass gear rewards. And I have the Gauntlet Energy Booster and the Leg Armor Energy Booster. If I'm reading that properly, then that means like if a set of gauntlets drop, it'll drop at like 6 or 7 energy as opposed to just 1 or 2. Next up, we've got the Scrounger bonus. So grants a chance for an additional piece of season pass gear to drop in various activities. And right now, I'm at the Strike Armor Scavenger. So more than likely when I play strikes, well, I'll get a chance at some seasonal gear. Then there's a seasonal bonus here, and we gain Signal Strength and also Sundial Spire rewards. So grants progression and also will give you a boost to your rewards to seasonal activities. Then lastly, we have this one here, Time Lost Arsenal Bonuses. Permanently unlocks access to time lost weapons that contain an alternate final perk. And I saw this on Twitter, a few people who have gotten this high up. Yeah, you can get a roll on something from the sundial or the time lost weapons that has an additional perk column, I believe. So now we will talk about a little bit of kind of cheese, or I'm going to call it semi-cheese. It's not full-blown cheese, maybe Velveeta cheese, okay? And it might be a little controversial, but just bear with me. We'll get to it. Let's talk about bounties. Now, I'm going to link an article from Paul Tassi from Forbes magazine. And he pretty much lists everything in terms of the bounty XP that you should be doing. Now, one of the unfortunate things about this particular season is that the Sundial and the Obelisks, well, the Obelisks, they're the ones that have the bounties. Each one of them has 2 weekly bounties, and they do give you a lot of XP. I believe it's 12,000, but they're a little grueling. It's not like the Vex Offensive where you had 2 weeklies and then you'd log in and just have simple, easy daily ones and also repeatables. But here's the ones that you want to be focusing on, or at least I would focus on, and what I am focusing on. You could see I'm just checking which bounties I need to get done during strikes, and there's a little bit of a cheese that you can do with this, which, well, you know, I'll just tell you about it now. If you have a particular bounty that you need done, you could be that guy and just go into the Vanguard Strike playlist, and then as soon as you spawn in, depending on the destination, you just go off to a lost sector and complete your bounties there, whether it's getting bow kills or scout rifle kills or linear fusion rifle kills or super, whatever it is, you can go do that. And then you'll eventually get pulled forward, or if the person knows what you're doing, they more than likely will wipe and then force you to go forward. And you probably probably can get reported for it. I don't know. I've done it a couple of times, but for the most part, the Vanguard strikes are easy, and you can get all of your bounties done. Just keep track of them and start swapping weapons throughout the strike. You'll be fine. The bounties I like the most are the Vanguard bounties, the Banshee Gunsmith bounties, and of course, the Moon bounties. All of them are so easy to get done in, I don't know, less than a half hour, maybe even like 45 minutes, depending on which ones you get, because it is random, or at least the repeatables are random. The Crucible ones are easy too, but I am just so not in the mood to play Crucible, I'll deal with that another time. But that's what I like. But let's go through some of the XP from this article from Paul Tassi from Forbes. He writes about Destiny nonstop. But anyway, and I will link this in the description if you want to just read it. So the Eris bounties, right? So daily bounties typically are 6,000. The repeatables are 4,000. And Eris's weekly bounties are 12,000. The Lectern, it's kind of the same thing. The weeklies are 12,000. The repeatables are 4,000. The dailies are 6,000. Now, we don't have Ikora anymore, but don't sleep on the EDZ, or Titan, or Io, or Nessus, or Mercury, or Mars for that matter. Their planetary bounties are 6,000 XP, so that's good. And like when I was doing the Obelisk bounty for the EDZ, where I had to grab all of the destination materials, and then also get a few Fallen Captain kills, Sniper kills, I grabbed Devrin K's bounties because usually they're super simple. Do 2 Lost Sectors, do 2 public events, get a few chests, and yeah, that's 6,000 XP per bounty. Moving along here, stay away from the Tangled Shore and Dreaming City. Their bounties are only worth 1,000 XP. Total waste of time. Same thing with Spider's Wanted bounties and the Petra Challenge bounties. They're only worth 3,000 and 2,000. Not worth your effort. The Crucible, Strike, Banshee, they're all pretty much the same. The weeklies are 12,000, the dailies are 6,000, and the repeatables are 4,000. Gambit's another big one too, and Gambit, well, the Drifter, he's got a ton of different bounties to get, so if you're grinding Gambit, just go in and grab all of those bounties. If we look at Gambit here, the daily bounties are 6,000, the Gambit Civic Duty daily bounties are 1,000, the Gambit repeatables are 4,000. And of course, he's got weekly bounties, and those will be 12,000 XP. So once you get a whole bunch of them completed, well, what you want to do is, if you have friends that are going to be online, well, then you could just join on them. And as you saw in the intro clip, when I went to my character inspection, I had what's called shared wisdom. Now, what if someone or none of your friends are online at that particular moment? This is where it gets a little dicey here, because it's a little bit of a cheese, but if you message the person, there's one particular area that I'm going to say go to, because I'd say 95 to 99% of the time, this works. So what I do is I put on my ghost shell, which I never take off anyway, which has a 10% buff to XP, which is Guiding Light. I go to the moon, and I go to Sorrow's Harbor, where you have Altars of Sorrow. And I find that 99% of the time, there's at least 1 to 2 people there that has their fire team open. I then check my character to see that I have the shared wisdom buff going, and I'm on PC, right? So I can just simply send them a text chat, which I usually do, but for the sake of this video, I didn't. I just joined on this person, and then I helped them finish Altars of Sorrow. And that's usually what I do. That's the right thing that you should do, because you don't want to get reported. But what I do is I join in them, I check and see, well, first off, when you fly in, check and see if there is someone that's available, right? And if there's no one there, and a lot of times there's no one there, just re-fly into the landing zone, and you will find a group or someone there that is open. And for the most part, I've had no issues, guys. I'll join in them, and then we'll finish the run, and then we'll emote, and then we'll say goodbye to each other, okay? So here, in this particular run, I see a bunch of people there, so I take a look at the roster, and sure enough, well, no one was there. Or there was a team there, but no one was open. So I just re-fly in, I'm going to join on someone, it will give me a different instance, and then from there, I can join on someone. And if it's not cool, what you do is just send them a quick text chat on PC, say, hey, do you mind if I join you and just pop my bounties and then I'll help you finish the run of altars? Most of the time, I'll just join in them, pop my bounties, and then finish the altars run with them. And we just emote, say goodbye, and that's pretty much it. I've had no issues with it whatsoever. So I'm flying in again, just checked it a few times, and then I think this time is going to be the magical one where I join in someone, and I can then pop all my bounties, and then I will finish the run of Altars of Sorrow to help them out. That's the right thing to do. You want to just jump in, join in them, pop your bounties, and then leave, because that's kind of a D-I-C-K move, if you know what I mean. So here, we got 3 people open, right? So I join on Leroy Jenkins here. Hey, you're in the video now. So I join in him, and then I'm going to check my character to see that I have shared wisdom. I then quickly pop all of my bounties, and then I just go about and finish the Altars of Sorrow run with them, and we're cool as cucumbers. No issues whatsoever. And it was fun, and we emoted at the end, and that was it. So that's what I'm going to suggest is if you're alone, if you're by yourself, is to try to join on someone, send them a quick message, or send them a PC text chat if you're on PC, and you'll be good to go. And there I hit rank 44. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you found it helpful and enjoyable. If you did, let me know in the comment section, and that's it. So leave me a hashtag made it to the end if you did make it to the end. If you'd like to further support this channel and become a channel member, click the link in the description. We've got an awesome channel member Discord and an awesome community that I would love for you to be a part of. And that's it, guys. Drop a like on this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter at MesaShawn. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube. And that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.